Occidente desde la India en este momento, la Europa de hoy.
Well, there's more awareness of Europe. You must remember, because of its historical connections, India was almost completely Anglo-centric, both in Europe and later the US. That's mainly, initially, a language connection. Perhaps because of the expansion of Europe, the formation of the Union. I think perhaps there is now a greater awareness of Europe as a continent. More and more students, for example, coming to Europe. The US still remains the favorite destination, but more and more students are coming to Europe outside England, to Germany and France particularly. All that rest of it, trade, commerce, etc., has all exploded. I think that's true. India is looking outward. Increasingly, there's also an eye towards China, with whom, as you know, India has had this very long, very checkered history. No, India, it's bound to look outward because of, when economic conditions improve. Money power increases, there is a tendency then to look outward, so that's inevitable too.
Sí, ha mencionado China, estamos ya casi entrando en el tiempo en el que vamos a abrir las preguntas, así que se me han quedado muchísimas por hacer, pero ya que ha mencionado China, se ha dicho algo terrible, es decir, que China es probable que avance más porque no es una democracia. Y que la India a lo mejor se va a quedar más atrás teniendo un potencial, sobre todo humano, mucho más preparado porque es una democracia. O sea, ¿usted qué piensa de esto? Aquí no hay nadie, o sea, puede hablar, ya sé que es funcionario y del Ministerio de Defensa, nada más, ¿no? o sea, pero puede contárnoslo porque no hay nadie de la embajada, o sea, que hay un problema.
It's really one of the great strengths. It's really, I say this, democracy in India is the real marvel. I've handled elections myself, so I know it's more than a marvel, it's a miracle. It's a poor country still, very large chunks of it are still very poor. But despite the poverty, the voter, the poorest of the poor, is democratically so aware and so involved in his right to vote that it really, as I said, it's a miracle. I mean, it really seems the greatest strength that, two of the greatest strengths of the country. One, that democracy works, despite all the complications of a poor country that's at the same time so huge and with such a large population. Democracy works. The other thing that works is that despite all those divisive factors, it's still one recognizable unit as a country. And you still feel that yes, this whole huge thing, despite all its diversity, is one fundamental unit. This is not something that can be understood unless you've spent time there, unless you've sensed that feeling within the way the country works. It's difficult to explain. Democracy is more easily palpable when you travel. It's a great sign of democracy. Everywhere you go, there's tremendous and continuous criticism of the government. At the same time, not for one moment would anyone actually prefer a system not democratic. China's a special case for us because, as I said, historically, China and India go back thousands of years. It's only that in the last, say, 50 or 60 years, the 1962 invasion by China truly upset, if I can say so, the Indian psyche. I don't think we've recovered yet. But still, the moment there is some kind of thaw in relations, I think we Indians are very ecstatic. China for us is still very, not only important, but I think dear, in the sense that we do see it as a great sort of Asiatic friend. But we have some way to go before he can actually.
Bien, pues si les parece.